Hello friends, I am Dr. Prashant Sharma and you are watching MEDICO'S Hub. In this video on dental anatomy, I am going to discuss a question: describe the morphology of primary mandibular first molar. So overall length, it is 15.8 mm, in which crown is 6 mm and the root is 9.8 mm long. Then mesiodistal diameter of the crown is 7.7 mm, and at the cervix it is 6.5 mm. The labiolingual diameter of the crown is 7 mm while at the cervix it becomes 5.3 mm. First of all, we'll discuss the buccal aspect. Crown. Mesial outline is almost straight, resulting in little constriction of the crown at the cervix. So we can observe that this is the mesial outline and it is almost straight, and there is a little constriction in the crown at the level of cervix. Distal outline converges more than usual, so the contact area extends distally to a marked degree. This is the distal outline. So distal outline is more convex, but mesial outline is less convex or almost straight. Distal portion of the crown is shortened than mesial. Cervical line dip apically where it joins the mesial root. We can observe that cervical line is dipping apically towards the bifurcation of root. Two distinct buccal cusps are seen with the developmental depression in between. It is not a developmental groove but developmental depression. This is the developmental depression, and the two cusps which are observed are mesial cusp, which is larger, and the distal cusp, which is smaller. So this is mesial cusp, that is mesiobuccal cusp, which is larger, and the distobuccal cusp, which is smaller. Then roots. Roots are long and slender. We can observe that there are two roots, distal root and mesial root. Mesial root is longer and distal root is shorter. These spread greatly at apical third and beyond the outline of the crown. This is the outline of the crown, and this distal root is especially going beyond the outline of crown. From the buccal aspect, if a line is drawn from the bifurcation of the roots up to the occlusal surface, the tooth is evenly divided mesiodistally. So this line will divide the tooth into two equal parts mesiodistally. But the mesial portion of the crown is twice as tall as distal portion, and also the mesial root is one-third longer than the distal root. So mesial root is longer. It gives a strange and primitive look, and it appears that in the past division of a single tooth ended in a strange condition. Now the lingual aspect. The crown. The crown and root converge at a marked degree. This is the crown and root that converge at a marked degree. Two distinct buccal cusps are seen with a developmental groove in between, mesiolingual cusp and the distolingual cusp. So this is the mesiolingual cusp and this is the distolingual cusp. Distolingual is small size while the mesiolingual cusp is large sized. And this is a reason which is dividing the mesiolingual and the distolingual cusp. First is mesiolingual cusp, long with sharp tip. This is long with sharp tip of the mesiolingual cusp. It is very sharp in comparison to any other cusp and almost centered lingually, but in line with the mesial root, it is the highest and longest cusp. We can observe that it is the highest and longest cusp. Distolingual cusp, that is another, it is less developed or small sized and it is rounded. Next is mesian marginal ridge. It is well developed. As mesiobuccal crown length is greater than mesiolingual crown length, cervical line slants upwards buccolingually. You can observe that cervical line, it slants upwards buccolingually. All the primary molars possess flattened buccal surfaces above the cervical ridge. Now the roots. Two roots are being observed. First one is mesial root. We can observe here. Another one is distal root. A developmental depression usually proceeds throughout the length. This is the developmental depression which is proceeding. Outline the mesial root does not resemble any of the primary two. Now distal root. This one is distal root. Buccal and distal outlines are straight and parallel for almost half of the length. You can also that this is almost parallel, slightly diverging from each other, and taper only slightly at the apical third. And root end is almost flat and square. So this is about the lingual aspect. Now the distal aspect. It is different from typical ones as cervical line does not drop buccally, length of crown is more uniform buccally and lingually, and the cervical line is almost straight buccolingually. The distal cusp, which include distobuccal and distolingual cusp, are not as long as sharper as the two mesial cusp. The distal marginal ridge is less straight and defined in comparison to the mesial marginal ridge. If distal root is observed, then it is more round, short and tapers more apically. Now the occlusal aspect. The general outline appears to be rhomboidal. The mesiobuccal prominence is seen. This is mesial. This is distal. This is lingual. And this one is buccal. So this is the mesiobuccal prominence. The mesiobuccal line angle is higher than distobuccal line angle. Mesiolingual cusp. We can observe that this is the mesiobuccal cusp, this is the distobuccal cusp, this is the distolingual cusp, and this one is mesiolingual cusp. So mesiolingual cusp, it is largest and best developed with broad flattened surface lingually. It is most developed. The two buccal grooves are evenly divided by buccal developmental groove, which is short and extend up to the central pit. This is the central pit. This is buccal developmental groove, and it is evenly divided these two grooves. The central developmental groove, it join it at central pit and extend mesially, dividing the mesiobuccal cusp and the mesiolingual cusp. It continues further to divide the mesiobuccal cusp and the mesiolingual cusp. Central groove ends in a mesial triangular fossa from where two supplemental grooves extend, one buccally and one lingually. This is the central groove, one buccally and one lingually. The mesiobuccal ridge, it possesses a well-defined triangular ridge which terminates buccolingually at the central developmental groove. Then lingual developmental groove, it extends lingually from this point, dividing the mesiolingual cusp and the distolingual cusp. This is the mesiolingual cusp and this is the distolingual cusp, and the lingual developmental groove, which this is the lingual developmental groove, it is dividing these two lingual cusps. It usually ends at the junction of lingual cusp ridges. This is the lingual cusp ridge. Some supplemental grooves immediately mesial to the distal marginal ridge in the distal triangular fossa join with the central developmental groove. So this is all about the occlusal aspect of the primary mandibular first molar. Hit the like button, share and subscribe our channel to get the latest updates and notifications.